assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard from me. Many years ago, as I was in my prayer room, I was about to go to work, and when I got up from my knees after much prayer, and as I was walking out of the room, I heard a voice behind me inside the room, very softly, very gently, very caring and tender, that said to me, 5 more minutes, 5 more minutes. Immediately I stopped. I got overwhelmed with such a voice and I began to weep, because I understood that the Creator of the universe, the Lord of Lords, the King of Kings, by His Spirit wanted nothing more than to spend time with His creation. 5 more minutes, He said, and He touched me. The Holy Spirit was given to us as a promise. Jesus just said through His word that He has spoken to His disciples that the Father had promised to give them something, and that that promise was coming. On the day of Pentecost, that promise came. And that promise has been with us, those that believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, ever since. That promise is nothing and no one more than the Holy Spirit of God, God Himself. Because the Holy Spirit is God Himself. So when the Lord, the Father of the universe, said, I promise you the Holy Spirit, He was promising Himself being poured out upon all creation and upon His sons and His daughters. The promise of promises was fulfilled 2,000 years ago on the day of Pentecost. And whoever becomes partaker of that promise, the Holy Spirit, through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, will come into the divine economy, the divine kingdom, and the divine nature, and their life will never be the same again. May you receive the promise of the Father, which is the promise of the Holy Spirit. I bless you, and I pray that you will receive the promise.